Morning, my dear students. So in this session we are going to learn the 8th problem on the cantilever beam. So we are going to solve with the help of Goodman-Lane equation method. So I will read the question. A cantilever beam. The cantilever beam is nothing but the one end of the beam is fixed and another end of the beam is free into the atmosphere. So we can say as cantilever beam. Is it right? So here the one end is fixed and another end is free. Is it right? A cantilever beam made of cold drawn carbon steel. Is it right? So it is made of carbon steel of a circular cross sections as shown in a figure, is subjected to a load which varies from minus CF to 3F. Always you need to remember, if force is acting in an upward direction, we need to consider as minus F. If it is force is move in a downward direction, then we need to consider as plus. Okay, minus F and plus 3F. Determine the maximum load member. So in this case, we need to find out the maximum load member can withstand for an indefinite life using factor of safety. So in this case, the factor of safety is given as 2 and the theoretical stress concentration factor. Here, the theoretical stress concentration factor, it is represented by KT. The KT value is given as 1.4. And the notch sensitivity is 0.9. So notch sensitivity is given as 0.9 is given. So it is considered the value, it is represent the Q equal to 0.9. Assume the following value, the ultimate strength of the material is given as sigma U is given as 550 megapascal. And yield stress of the material is given as 470 megapascal. The yield stress is represented by sigma y. Sigma u how much is given? 550 megapascal. And sigma y is given as 470 megapascal. Is it right? And the endurance limit sigma e is given as 275 megapascal. And the size factor K size is given as 0.85. You know very well, if it is K size factor, K surface finishing factor, if it is not given, then you need to consider as 1. But always you need to remember one thing, if it is made of low carbon steel material, then K surface finishing factor should be 0.87. If it is not given, then you need to consider as 0.87 for the K size factor. For the K surface finishing factor is 0.85. Already we solved in the last problem. Is it right? Here, the K size factor is given as 0.85 is given in the question, and the surface finishing factor is 0.89 is given. Is it right? And if you look this figure, it is looking like a step bar. Okay, here this diameter is greater than this diameter. So this diameter how much is given? 20 mm, and this is 30 mm. The total length of this specimen is 150, and step bar from free end to from A to B end is 125 mm is given in this case. In the last problem, we know very well, if the load is acting at the center point, then we are using the bending moment formula is W max into length by 4. But here in this case, the load is acting where? At the free end. If the load is acting at the free end, then you need to use the formula is W max into length. How much? Only load into length. Minimum load into length. Maximum load into length. Is it right? Done. I will represent here given data. So here maximum load, how much is acting at the free end? The maximum load is 3F and the minimum load is acting at this free end is minus F. Is it right? And the length of this specimen is, total length is 150. Okay, here. And then ultimate strength of the material, how much is given here, dear? Sigma U is given as 550 megapascal. So 550 megapascal. So we know very well 1 megapascal should be equal to 1 newton per millimeter square. Is it right? 1 megapascal should be equal to 1 newton per millimeter square. So here we can represent the value is 550. Instead of megapascal, we can represent the value as newton per millimeter square. Okay, newton per millimeter square. Then, and the yield stress is given as sigma y. How much is given here? 470 megapascal. Then we can represent here 470 megapascal, nothing but newton per millimeter square. And the endurance limit of this material is given as 275. Sigma E equal to 275 megapascal, 275 newton per millimeter square. Okay, and K size factor, K size, how much is given here? 0.85. And K surface finishing factor, K surface finishing factor is given as 0.89. Is it right? Again, here determine the maximum load. We need to find out the value of F. Okay. And the theoretical stress concentration factor, how much is given here? KT, or we can represent theoretical stress concentration factor is given as how much? 1.4. And the factor of safety of this material is given as 2. No sensitivity is given as 0.9. So the no sensitivity is represented by Q equal to how much? 0.9. Is it right? Then I will solve the problem one by one. So here the first thing is, what we need to find out? We need to find out the maximum bending moment. So here, where the maximum bending moment is acting? The maximum bending moment is acting where? At the free end. Is it right? Then we can represent here. If the load is acting at the free end, it should be effect on whom? On the section A and B. Is it right? Maximum bending moment, where here? At the point A. Okay. So here the load is acting at the free end, it will be affect on the portion on whom, dear? On the A and B section. Is it right? For that reason I represent here the maximum bending moment at the point is A. Okay. M max, maximum bending moment equal to. So if the load is acting in the center, okay, if the load is acting in the center, which formula we have to use? W max into length by 4. Is it right? W max into length by 4. But here, load is where is it acting? The load is acting at the free end. If the load is acting at the free end, then there is no need to use by 4 formula. Just you need to remember W max, maximum load into length. Okay, dear?
W max, maximum load.
Maximum load is how much is there? 3F. Okay, we can represent here 3F into length of the specimen. How much is given? From here to here. From here to here. It should be how much? It should be 125. How much here? 125. If you multiply 125 into 3, it should be 375. How much here?
375F. That is the value of maximum bending moment is acting at a point A.
Okay. Again, what do we need to find out? We need to find out how much minimum load, how much minimum bending moment is acting at point A. We need to find out. Is it right? Then I can represent here minimum bending moment minimum bending moment at point where? At A. Is it right? Then we have to use the formula, same formula we have to use. Minimum bending moment, the minimum bending moment should be equal to minimum load. Which load? Minimum load into length. Okay, here the minimum load is how much is there? Here minus F. Okay, minus F. And the length is from free end to end A. How much length is given here? 125 mm length is given here. Then we need to consider as minus 125F. That is the value of minimum bending moment. So then what will be the unit? Okay, the unit of load is Newton. The unit of length is mm. Is it right? Newton mm we can represent here. Okay, here. Then we find out the maximum bending moment and the minimum bending moment. What we need to find out? We need to find out the mean bending moment, as well as what we need to find out? We need to find out the variable bending moment. We need to find out. After that, we need to find out the mean bending stress, as well as variable bending stress. We need to find out. Okay, here. Next one is, we need to find out mean bending moment. We need to find out. Okay, here. If you want to find out the mean bending moment, then you need to represent as mean bending moment should be equal to the maximum bending moment plus minimum bending moment by 2. Then you will get the value of mean bending moment. Which formula we have to use? Maximum bending moment plus minimum bending moment by 2. Then you will get the value of mean bending moment. Okay. Maximum bending moment plus minimum bending moment by 2. Here the maximum bending moment is 375 force. Is it right? 375F plus the minimum bending moment is minus 125F. Is it right? Minus 125F by 2. Is it right? 375F minus 125F by 2. Is it right? Then you will get the value of 125F. How much will you get here?
125F. If you subtract this value and by 2, then you will get the value of 125F. What will be the unit? Newton millimeter. Is it right? That is the value of mean bending load.
Again, what we need to find out? We need to find out the variable bending moment. If you want to find out the variable bending moment, which formula you have to use? Variable bending moment should be equal to maximum bending moment minus minimum bending moment by 2. Then you will get the value of variable bending moment. So I will solve here in the next board. The next is, we need to find out the variable bending moment. We need to find out. If you want to find out the variable bending moment, then you need to use the formula is mv equal to the maximum bending moment minus minimum bending moment by 2. Okay, the maximum bending moment is how much is that here? 375 F, minus minimum bending moment is minus 125 F by 2. Okay dear, then if you add, minus into minus should be plus. 375 F plus 125 F by 2. If you divide, then you will get the value of 250 F. I'm getting here 250 F. Dear, in the mean bending moment is 125. Variable bending moment, how much we got it here? 250 F. Okay, what will be the unit? Newton mm. Okay, the next step, what we need to find out? We need to find out the section modulus. We need to find out. Is it right? If you want to find out the section modulus, which formula we have to use here? Section modulus. So what is the formula is that here? Z equal to pi by, tell me, 32 d cube. Is it right? Then pi by 32 as it is d. D is how much is given? The diameter of the first section from the free end to A is 13 mm. How much is given? 13. Is it right? Whole cube. If you divide this term, then you will get the answer is how much? 215.7. So what will be the unit? The unit of the section modulus is mm cube. On what basis we have to tell about the mm cube? Because of the diameter unit is mm. Is it right? Mm. Power is how much is there? Cube. Then that's what we have to represent the unit is. If you divide this term, then you will get the value is 215.7 mm cube. Is it right? That is the value of section modulus. It is represented by Z. Okay. Again, what we need to find out? We need to find out the mean bending stress, as well as we need to find out the variable bending stress. We need to find out. Okay, dear. Mean bending stress, we need to find out. For the mean bending stress, so how to represent here? Sigma m equal to, so we are talking about mean bending stress, nothing but m, is it right? By section modulus Z. So how much we got it here? Mean bending moment is 125 F. Okay, how much we got it? Mean bending moment is 125 F by section modulus is how much we got it here? 215.7. Is it right? 215.7. If you divide this term, then you will get the value is 0.587. Is it right? F is as it is. Okay, not here. Then what will be the unit? The unit of stress is Newton per mm square. That is the unit of mean bending stress value. Again, what we need to find out? Variable bending stress we need to find out. For the variable bending stress, which formula we have to use here? Sigma V equal to MV by section modulus. Is it right? Then sigma MV, how much we got it here? MV we got it as 250 F. Is it right? 250 F. The section modulus value, how much? 215.7.
215.7.
If you divide this term, then you will get the value is 1.16. Is it right?
1.16 F. That is the value of variable bending stress. Okay, here.
The unit will be Newton per millimeter square. That is the value of variable bending stress. We got it. After that, what we need to find out here, you know very well, no sensitivity is given, is it right? And theoretical stress concentration factor is given here. So for that reason, we need to find out the fatigue stress. We need to find out, is it right?
Fatigue stress concentration factor we need to find out.
Okay. If you want to find out the fatigue stress concentration factor, which formula we have to use here? Tell me.
Kf. Fatigue stress concentration factor should be equal to 1 plus no sensitivity Q into KT theoretical stress concentration factor minus of 1.
Okay dear, so which formula we have to use here? Fatigue stress concentration factor should be equal to 1 plus Q. Q is given, the no sensitivity is given. KT theoretical stress concentration factor, KT minus of 1. Okay,
here 1 plus
Q, how much is given here?
0.9,
and KT is given as 1.42
minus of 1.
So if you are calculate with the help of Calc, then you will get the value is 1.378. That is the value of fatigue stress concentration factor value. Okay dear, then again what we need to find out with the help of Goodman equation, we need to find out the value of force. How much force is acting at the free end we need to find out, as well as we need to consider the maximum load. How much is acting at the free end we need to find out, is it right? Then I am using the Goodman-Lang equation formula. So with the help of Goodman-Lang equation formula, we need to find out the value of F. We need to find out. The formula is 1 by M, N equal to sigma M by sigma U, okay, plus sigma V by sigma E into Kf by K surface finishing factor into K size factor. Is it right? Then 1 by N, N nothing but the factor of safety. The factor of safety is given as 2. Is it right?
1 by 2. 1 by 2 nothing but 0.5.
Is it right? Mean stress, sigma M. Sigma M how much is given here?
0.587F
by sigma U.
Sigma U how much? 550. Is it right?
550 mega Pascal.
Okay, ultimate stress point is 550. Variable stress sigma V
1.16F. Sigma E value
275.
Okay, into KF
stress concentration factor is how much is given here? 1.378. Is it right?
1.378 is given.
So I told you, if the KF value, if it is not given, then you need to consider as 1. Is it right? Then here, K surface finishing factor also given. How much? 0.89. Good. And K size factor, how much is given here? 0.85 is given. Okay, dear. Then the first thing is you need to divide by 1/2. Then you will get the value is 0.5. If you divide 0.587 divided by 550, then you will get the value of 0.00105 F plus. First thing is you need to multiply in such way that 1.16 into 1.378. First you need to multiply. After that, you need to divide by whole. 275 into 0.89 into 0.85. Then you will get the accurate answer. Okay. Then you will get 0.00768 F. Okay. After that, you need to add this term. Then you will get the value is 0.087, again 0.8773 F and 0.5. Again, what we need to find out? Actually, our intention is we need to find out the value of F. We need to find out. That's what you need to divide by 0.5 divided by 0.00873, then you will get the answer is 57.3. Okay, 0.5 divided by 0.00873. If you divide 0.5 divided by 0.0873, then you will get the answer is 57.3 Newton. Okay, first. Again, second, we need to find out the value of force F. Okay. So in this case, we are considering the Goodman equation. Again, we need to consider the Soderberg equation. Why we need to consider the Soderberg equation? Because of here, ultimate stress is given. Meanwhile, the yield stress is given. If it is yield stress is given, then you need to use the Soderberg equation. With the help of Soderberg equation, you need to find out the value of F. Okay. Let us see over here. Soderberg equation . So here, what is the formula is there? 1 by n equal to sigma m by sigma y plus sigma v by sigma e into kf by k surface finishing factor into k size factor. What we have to change here? Just we need to change this term. Okay, 1 by n as it is. Sigma m nothing but mean stress by sigma y nothing but yield stress. Here in the Goodman line, ultimate stress. Is it right? Sigma m by sigma y plus variable stress as it is by endurance stress as it is into kf stress concentration factor. Whatever the value is given, you need to consider the same k surface finishing factor as well as k size factor. Okay, dear. Then 1 by n nothing but 0.5 sigma m. How much is given? 0.587 F. Is it right? By sigma y. How much is given? Sigma y is given as 470. How much? 470 megapascal. Is it right? Or we can say as 470 Newton per millimeter square. Plus sigma v value, how much? 1.16 F. By sigma e, how much? 275 Newton per millimeter square. Stress concentration factor, how much is given here? 1.378. K surface finishing factor, 0.89. and K size factor 0.85. Okay, dear. Then, so 1 by 0.5. Sorry, here n nothing but 2. If you divide 1 by 2, then you will get the value of 0.5. If you divide 0.587 divided by 470, then you will get the value of 0.00123. Remaining is F plus. Dear, don't do the mistake here. First thing is you need to multiply 1.16 into 1.378 divided by 275 into 0.89 into 0.85. Then you will get the value of 0.00768F. Okay, then if you add 0.00123F plus 0.00768F, then you will get the value of 0.0891F and 0.5. You need to divide this term 0.5 by 0.0891 equal to F. So if you divide with the help of calci 0.5 by 0.0891, then you will get the value of force is 56 Newton. Here, which one is the maximum force is acting? If you use the Goodman equation, how much maximum force is acting here? 57. So this means that Goodman equation force should be greater than the Soderbergh equation force. Is it right? So that's what you need to consider the larger force. The larger force is, which one is there? Goodman equation force. How much? F equal to 57.3 Newton you need to consider. Okay? If you have the doubt regarding this class, please write down in the comment box and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you. Here 0.0891 here, okay? 0.0891, then you will get the value of 56 Newton, okay dear? Thank you.